Hello. In this video, we are going to introduce cluster analysis using the k-means method. And one way that I like to teach this is to use a deck of playing cards to build out cluster assignments. However, because we are in an online environment, I can't have all of you huddle around a poker table and sling out, cut the cards, shuffle, and start playing the game. So I've illustrated this concept over the next couple of slides, and I hope you enjoy, and I hope it's helpful to you. Cluster analysis, in general, is a machine learning technique with a bit of artificial intelligence sprinkled in. But then at the end of the day, folks, you are driving. Okay? You are the driver. So you have to use business acumen to study the results. So what is K and how many clusters should we have? Well, K is the number of clusters. So it's a mathematical algorithm component. K equals however many clusters you want to run as a data scientist. Do you want to run 5? Do you want to run 100? Do you want to run 1? Well, go ahead, but it's going to be useless to you because by default, when you're not running any clusters, you already have one cluster. By not having clusters, you have one cluster. So you could literally run one cluster, and if the program doesn't refuse you, doesn't vomit out, crash out, it will give you back what you put into it. Everybody will be assigned to cluster 1. Do you want 2 clusters? Well, try it. Do you want 2,000 clusters? Well, try it. But it won't work unless you have tens, if not hundreds of thousands of customers with plenty of variation in behavior. So the lesson here is every customer is going to be assigned a cluster. If you have 100 customers and you want 101 clusters, well, guess what? It's impossible to reach that because the algorithm requires that each cluster has an assignment. So we're going to start looking at the cards here in a second. So the algorithm, to start the algorithm, we're going to create random cluster centers. So the word random there, it's like we're playing dice, right? Just random dice roll, or just like shuffling cards and we're playing a game of war. Whatever gets thrown out, it's a game of chance. There's no choice. There's no human intervention at this point. There will be later, but not right now. So using the iterative process, it runs each time there's a new observation added to the algorithm. And this will be important later because in SAS, you'll be given the opportunity to actually change each time a new observation is added, or wait until all 52 cards in your deck or all observations have been assigned, and then do it again as an iterative process. For your homework, I'm going to have you not do that, and I'll talk about that in a future video. So the objective of cluster analysis is to reduce the distance. So minimize the distance between observations and their assignments. Because think about it like a dance floor. Okay? A traditional high school dance. Okay, you have a bunch of people, men and women, teachers. I guess they're also men and women. But you got students, teachers, males, females, etc. Right? And there's a dance. They're dancing to music. You have a group of people that are sitting at tables. You have a group of people that are against a wall. That's why you call them wallflowers. And then you've got people mingling. But even within that group of people that are mingling and dancing, some of them are dancing as a group of friends. Some of them are really close with hand on the waist and another hand clasped in a traditional ballroom kind of thing. Some people might be doing salsa. Some people might be doing tango. Some people might be doing the formal waltz. My point is, even within dancing, so we're looking at the people that are dancing. Even within the people that are dancing, there is different closeness, right? Like if you're just, snapping your fingers, moving your arms up and down, moving your head, that's not very involved compared to the people that are snuggling as they dance. Person lay, has their head on a shoulder kind of thing. So we're talking about closeness. Minimal distance from each other suggests that they are closer together. Okay, in terms of customers, the more similar your buying patterns are to another customer, the less distance there is between you because there's less variation. If you go to the grocery store at 7 in the morning and buy peanut butter and jelly every Monday, and your neighbor does the same exact thing 7 in the morning every Monday, buys the same product all the time, pays the same way as you do, then you are going to be extremely close. You're going to be on top of each other, statistically speaking. But if your neighbor goes at 8:30 and buys the same product, you'll have a little bit more distance. If your neighbor goes at 7 just like you, but instead of paying with cash, they pay with credit card, a little more distance is occurring. So anytime there's variation in the variables or the behavior, we're generating more distance. Okay. And what cluster analysis will do is it'll keep running until it figures out a way, mathematically, to minimize the distance between those XY coordinates. Okay, the formula is called the Euclidean distance. There's also the Manhattan distance as well. And this will repeat until no more improvements can be made. So let's play cluster cards. I made this game up, thought it was kind of ingenious, but then of course we're teaching in an online environment, so let's hope for the best. So we start with three cluster centers. Now, why is there three clusters? Because I told the program to make three clusters. If I wanted five, I could put five. If I wanted 700, I could put 700 clusters. But quite frankly, three clusters is a good demonstration for this screen size that we have. And I think it'll have enough variability. Now, because there's only one observation in each cluster, that is the cluster center. So three, if we were to do a scatter diagram, three would be the cluster center. Three, three, nine, nine, 10, 10, would be the cluster center. Now let's play the game. Let's draw a card. The card is a four of hearts. We are going to assign that four of hearts to cluster one. Not because there's a three of hearts there, or not because it's a heart card, but because of the calculation that we do. We try to find which number value the four is closest to using the absolute. So we don't care about negatives or positives. So three minus the four is one, nine minus the four is five. 10 minus the 4 is 6. So the 6, the 10, and the 9, or 6, sorry, 6, the 5, and the 1, which one is closest? Is it closer to the 3, the 9, or the 10? Well, the 4 is one away from the 3, so we're going to put it in cluster 1. Now, if we decide that we want the clusters to move every time we add a new observation, then this is what would happen. The cluster center is moving because 3 plus 4 divided by 2. So we take the average. 9 divided by 1 is 9. 10 divided by 1 is 10. But 3, 4, 7 divided by 2 is 3.5. So now the cluster center isn't 3, it's 3.5. So it's moving. It's moving. We always complete assignments based on the minimum distance, as I said before, with the dance floor example. It's wine customers based on their purchase behavior. Okay, the next card is the Jack. We'll treat that as an 11. So we assign it to the third cluster because of the math involved. It's a one, it's a distance of one away. Be a distance of two away from there and a distance of 7.5 from here. So again, just like the previous example, we now have a 10 plus an 11 divided by 2 gives us 10.5. Now the cluster for 3 is 10.5. And now we've got a 7 of clubs. And we are going to assign that here because it is 2 away from the second cluster. It's 3.5 away from the third cluster and 3.5 away from the first cluster. Okay. But now we got 9 plus 7 equals 16. Divide by 2 is 8. The cluster center is now 8. So it actually went down. It went further away from this one and down. It, just imagine a scatter diagram of these. This bubble is moving. Okay, so now imagine that we went through 52 cards or dozens of decks of cards. Let's just say we're playing blackjack at a casino. We have multiple decks. But all these cards that are flying in, because we started with the process with a random center, we need to shuffle the deck and redo this whole thing. Okay? It's kind of like playing solitaire where you're at the end of the deck, you pile it back up and you try again. Because we want to reduce the overall distance of all the cards out there. And this process is called mutation. We're mutating this data set. So let's say for argument, after doing these 300 cards, we now have cluster centers of 1.27, 7.34, 11.03. Where does the 4 of hearts go? Where do you think a 4 is going to go? We assign it to cluster 1 because 2.711 minus 4 is 1.289. 7.34 minus the 4 is 3.34. 11.03 minus 4 is 7. So the minimum distance, we assign it over here. Okay. Now the cluster center then moves from 2.711 to 3.555. Okay. And it creeps up a little bit, getting a little bit closer to cluster 2. Not quite, but still a little bit closer. So that, my friends, is a quick way to explain what happens when you add observations to a cluster analysis, where you each observation is assigned to a cluster based on the minimum distance to that cluster. So when does it end? It ends when there could be no more improvements in the model. How is the improvement decided? Well, we calculate the minimum distances for all observations. So even though we assign an observation to a cluster, right? That distance here gets summed up for all observations. All of the observations get a score. And the artificial intelligence will say, okay, I got a total of 687.243 for total distance. Let me mutate this again, right? Let's mutate this again and see if I can get a lower total distance for all the observations. If it can't, then it ends. But it could keep running until the end of time. Just so happens we have supercomputers and fast servers and things like that, where we don't have to wait till the end of the time anymore. Also of note, in SAS, you can also put in that you only want 3 mutations or permeations or iterations. Like, try it 3 times, try to improve it 3 times, and then just give me the results. Okay, we will keep reassigning everyone until the algorithm is satisfied with that no improvements to minimum distance can be made. So this is, my friends, why I call it machine learning plus AI sprinkled with a little bit of business acumen. The remaining videos will discuss how to set up your model, how to run it, and then the final video will talk about the business acumen because you are still in the driver's seat. Thank you.